Hello everyone, and thank you for attending this presentation. I'm Abdallah Deeb from InterDigital, and I will present our work entitled Practical Face Reconstruction via Differentiable Ray Tracing. 3D face reconstructions aim to reconstruct face given in various types of input sensors, such as HMC, mobile camera, multi-view rig setup, and so on. This has a wide range of application in the industry, such as VFX, VR, gaming, also in AR and telepresence, biometrics, reenactment and dubbing, and also on computer mobile devices as well. Here's the outline of the presentation. I will start by briefly talking about existing approaches for face reconstruction, and I will talk about the limitation of some of these existing approaches that we try to solve. I will then present the contribution of this work. Next, I will describe our method technically. Next, I will show you some visual results and applications and comparisons against state-of-the-art methods. Finally, I will discuss some limitation of the proposed approach, future work, and conclusion. So historically, there exist two types of approaches for face reconstructions and tracking. The dense captures that require some additional hardware such as HMC or multi-view rig setup. On the other hand, monocolor-based approaches has gained a lot of success recently. These approaches does not require any external hardware setup. We can mention here the work of Garrido et al., which is an optimization-based approach that achieves high-quality face reconstruction capture from a single video. Most of these methods relies on the 3DMM statistical geometry and albedo prior that adds a lot of structure to the problem and make it attractable. More recently, deep-based approaches such as the one introduced by Tiwari et al. Achieves real-time performance but sacrifices quality. In the Cats movie released in 2019 shown here, actors were not wearing any kind of motion capture devices. They were performing freely in the scene. Our team has been working with Technicolor artists to extract actors' performance in such challenging conditions. The only left options here was to extract facial performance from a single video. For this, we have developed FaceLab, technology that helped Technicolor artists save some considerable amount of time. This technology is based on the research work of Garrido et al. That extracts facial performance from a single input video without any external hardware. Here we show the reconstructions obtained by our FaceLab technology. We note that here for tracking, we use personalized mesh and blend shapes for every actor generated by artists. This example shows that we, with monocolor-based approaches, we can be used to generate premium content for film production. However, these monocolor-based approaches have some limitations that we have experienced when working on Cats movie. In fact, most existing monocolor-based methods assumes pure Lambertian BRDF to model face skin reflectance. That means that oily skin or specular highlights that appear on the face cannot be modeled, and even worse, it may degrade the tracking as we experienced in FaceLab technology. Additionally, the lighting model used is based on the low-order spherical harmonics, so that only distance lights can be modeled. Under heavy shadows, reconstructions and tracking may fail. So in this work, we address this problem in a practical way that I will present in the next. So our goal is to have a better light representation so that we can handle shadows properly and also have a better skin reflectance model. For this, the main contribution of the work are the following. First, we introduce for the first time ray tracing for face reconstructions. Because ray tracing is a natural way to model light geometry interaction, it has essentially built-in shadow supports. Additionally, ray tracing can handle high-frequency lighting and other complex effects in a more easier way. In our work, we use the implementation of Li et al. Of a differentiable ray tracer. Second, we introduce a novel parameterized virtual light stage to model light. This light stage is composed of 20 area lights sampled on icosahedron. Each light has the following parameters, position, surface, and intensity that are optimized. This virtual light stage allows to approximate point and infinite light as well. The last contribution of this work is the capture of personalized diffuse and specular albedos outside of the statistical albedo prior space while being robust against shadows. We'll introduce our problem formulations. We define P as a scene parameters composed of the following. The geometry. We shape identity from a 3D morphable model. The 3D morphable model was built from a set of pre-registered face scans in a common topology. Principal component analysis was used to build an orthogonal basis. This space has 18 vectors, so our goal is to find the coefficients for each vector that represent a new face. Expression also we call the blend shapes. This describes the different expressions that we can do, such as smile, mouth open, and so on. This also is represented as 75 coefficients that control each expression. So our goal is to find the expression coefficients that best describe the input image. The skin color here, again, we have 18 orthogonal vectors that can model different skin colors that we need to find these coefficients that best describe the input image. For the light, our parameterized light stage composed of 20 area lights, where each light has its own intensity, surface, and distance to origin. As illustrated on the right, the light stage is centered on the head face, and each parameterized light can change its surface position to the center, relative to the center, and its intensity. More details can be found in the paper. Finally, we have the rotation and translation of the head, which gives 6 parameters to estimate. So for the pose, it controls the rotation and translation of the head pose. For the entity, these coefficients define the face morphology, age, gender, and so on. Finally, for the expression, the magnitude of each coefficients control different face expression. The albedo or skin color, these coefficients allow us to model various types of skin. We use the albedo prior of Smith et al. That model diffuse and specular tone. And for the light, as seen, it defines how the light is perceived on the face. So now that we have defined our parametric face model, now within an inverse rendering problem, given an input image, we want to get the optimal set of parameters P that best describe the input image. So what we do is that we start from initial configuration of P, we call P0, where we initialize the head pose and the blend shapes using the detected landmarks. Then we generate a new synthetic image, which is then compared to the input image to calculate some kind of loss function or energy function. Our goal is to find these parameters that minimize this error. There are many ways to solve this problem. Here we use gradient descent from PyTorch. So it's an iterative optimization process where at each time step, we add an increment to the current estimate in a way that minimizes the error functions. We repeat this process a certain number of iterations till we reach a certain local minima. Now for the optimization within an inverse rendering framework, given a set of parameters P, we retrace an image and compare it to the input image. We calculate a loss function and then backpropagate over the scene parameters and we repeat this process a certain number of iterations. The following is the energy functions that we minimize. E-data is the data term composed of the photoconsistency and landmark term. The photoconsistency is the L1 norm between the retraced image and the input image. We add other regularizers to maintain stability of the optimization and remove non-plausible faces obtained by 3DMM. So this is what we get from this optimization at this level. Given an input image, we show the final reconstruction together with the estimated attributes, light, diffuse, and specular. It can be easily noted that the final reconstruction is still far from the real input image. This is because we are bound by the statistical albedo prior space that cannot model skins outside the span of its space, so that beard makeup are not captured. So to improve on this, we would like to go beyond the statistical albedo prior space and capture personalized albedo details. The challenge here is that we want to avoid overfitting because one can easily overfit the diffuse textures to explain the missing part in the image. We also want to avoid baking residual shadows in the final albedos. This is because our lighting model, based on the virtual light stage, may not perfectly explain all the shadows in the image, so we want to avoid baking unexplained shadows in the final albedos. We introduce a second optimization stage where we start from the optimized diffuse and specular term obtained from the first stage with constant roughness, and we optimize these three textures on a per pixel basis by minimizing the following energy function. We introduce two regularizers within the energy functions that we are minimizing that quickly regularize this optimized textures with respect to the original textures obtained by the first stage. These regularizers are the symmetry and consistency. The role intuitively is, for instance, if an area of the face is under shadow, this regularizer tries to keep the color value of this area close to the prior state. More technical details can be found in the paper. We obtain at different stages of the optimizations. So given an input image, this is the base reconstructions obtained within the statistical albedo prior space, where we show the final reconstruction to cover with the estimated diffuse, specular, and constant roughness. And this is what we obtain in the second stage, where we show the final reconstruction with the estimated personalized albedos. One can see the importance of the second stage to reconstruct at high fidelity the input image and capture personalized albedo without outside the span of the statistical albedo prior space. Here also we show some reconstruction results under challenging lighting condition. For each subject, we show the final reconstruction together with the estimated diffuse, specular, and roughness terms, and the estimated light with the projected shadows in the last column. Here I show some animated results obtained by our method. So for each subject, we show the reconstruction, the diffuse, and the specular shading. So here we rotate the face with the estimated light. Here with specular reflections around on the face that we see that we capture them. Here also in specular highlights on the face. These with personalized albedos. I will show some applications to our methods. So here we reconstruct Emily. And then we reconstruct this girl and we transfer the estimated light of this girl to Emily. And here we do the same. We estimate the light for this guy and we transfer the light estimated light to Emily. Here we show some relighting under different environment maps for different subjects. Here we show some other application which we call specular edit. The idea is to attenuate the specular highlights on the face. This is before, this is after. So this is the area where we by manipulating the specular and estimated specular and roughness, we can attenuate the specular highlights on the face. Here as well. Here we show shadow removal. So the idea is that we reconstruct this guy with the projected shadows on the nose. This is the estimated shadows. And then we manipulate the estimated light stage toward uniform light to remove the projected shadows on the nose. So this is the final reconstruction without the shadows on the nose. I'll show another examples of shadow removal. So given an input image, we first reconstruct and estimate the light using our method. Then we manipulate the estimated light stage toward uniform light configuration so that to remove projected shadows on the face. Here we show also comparison against spherical harmonics with different parameterizations, 3, 5, and 7 bands. It's noted that with higher order spherical harmonics, we can still get meaningful shadows in the scene, as shown with spherical harmonics 7 bands compared to 3 bands. But for the second subject, which has shadows projected on the nose, only the light stage can capture the shadows, while the other spherical harmonics parameterization cannot do. This is because they cannot model point lights in this case. Here we show some comparisons against recent state-of-the-art method. So for the first row is the input image. Then for each row, we show the reconstruction for each method. For instance, subjects under challenging lighting conditions, second and third subject, Yamaguchi bakes shadows in the estimated albedos as shown here. This is because Yamaguchi et al. Directly regress diffuse and specular albedos without any explicit light modeling in their formulation. For Smith, that only use statistical prior space so that makeup cannot be captured. For Latas, the last column, it produces plausible reconstructions with shadows-free albedos, but they do not provide final reconstructions. They only estimate diffuse and specular albedos. Here we show results on Emily. So the top row shows the ground truth data of Emily, and in the second row, we show our final reconstruction and the overlay of our reconstruction on the real image. And we also show the estimated diffuse specular and roughness of our method. We also show relighting of Emily for different methods, Latas, Smith et al, and Yamaguchi and ours. We compare against three methods for the final render, the second and third column here. We only compare against Smith et al because Yamaguchi and Latas does not estimate final reconstructions. They only regress diffuse and specular albedos. So for the final render, our method obtains the best score for SSIM and PSNR. For the diffuse and specular term, the last four columns, results are generally close, with Yamaguchi is slightly better than us, except for the diffuse SSIM, where we are slightly better than Yamaguchi. So here we show some limitations of our method. First, we may sometimes bake some albedo in the estimated light. This is because of the limitation of the statistical albedo prior space that cannot model all skin type, especially for person with colors. As shown here in red, the estimated albedo is not correct. Second, our method rely on landmarks to initialize and guide the optimization. In case these landmarks are inaccurate, as shown here, we may get stuck in a bad local minima, as shown here, and the estimated shape is inaccurate. It can be seen in highlighted here. Third, our method cannot model foreign or external shadows, which may get baked into final albedos. Finally, in some cases where the estimated light and subsequent shadows are inaccurate, some shadow patches may appear in the estimated albedo, as shown here in the estimated specular map, highlighted in red. Increasing the weights of our regularizers can help attenuate this, but this may sacrifice some albedo details. So, as a future work, the estimated geometry by our method is restricted to the statistical 3DMM space. We would like to capture more detailed geometry. Also, using a more complex skin reflectance model is interesting. Our method cannot handle foreign shadows. A method such as the one proposed by Zhang et al. For portrait shadow removal could be interesting in our case. Also, our method can naturally extend to multi-view or multi-frame setup, which help improve the estimated facial attributes and remove a lot of ambiguity. Finally, our method is slow and is sensitive to the initial starting point. A deep-based approach is very interesting to solve these limitations and add generalization capacity. So in this work, we present the first method that achieves high fidelity face reconstructions from a single image in general lighting conditions, where most state-of-the-art methods does not deal with challenging lighting conditions. We achieve state-of-the-art reconstruction results by introducing for the first time ray tracing for face reconstruction within an inverse rendering setup. The main advantage of ray tracing is that it can model complex light geometry interaction and naturally account for self-shadows. We also introduced a novel parameterized light stage to model point lights. We show that our optimization strategy allows us to capture personalized albedos outside statistical albedo prior space while being robust against extreme shadows. Thank you for your attention.